Here's a short follow-up on my microwave oven rewind video I did the other day on trying to modify a microwave oven transformer for low voltage use. So in my last video, I had two separate secondary windings. They were both 18 turns. And when those two windings were paralleled together, the current draw on the input to this was 5 amps. So on my last video, when I disconnected those two parallel windings from each other and essentially everything was floating, as it was really anyway, the line current only dropped to 3 amps at that point. So after digging on the internet, there was a bunch of sources that said you have to take the shunts out of the transformer. So I pounded the shunts out of it. There was like 6 layers roughly of laminated steel that went through the sides here, right above the primary on both sides. And then on top of them, there was like 4 or 5 copper wires that were shoved through on the top. It looked like some type of magnetic shading to me. They said the purpose of that was for current limiting in case of an overload on the transformer. They had also said in order to get the line current down, or they implied, it may be necessary to add turns onto the primary here. There's at least 144 turns on here, or just short of 144. So what I did is I cut all my other windings off I had on here the other day. And, you know, I've put so much time into this, it's absolutely kind of pathetic. I wound another 23 turns of wire right on top of the existing primary here, which are these two wires here. And I connected them in series with the primary, in the right phase, of course. So this wire was coming over to the terminal block, and this wire was going down onto the primary. And then I rewound a new secondary. So when I powered it up today, now it draws 4 amps. it draws even more current than it did the other day. So I thought, okay, let's take the additional turns off the primary and put the primary back to the way it was. As soon as I did that, this thing here just absolutely slammed. So, you know, take of that what you want. Kind of the way I look at this is don't believe anything you read on the internet. Because when you punch stuff into Google, it has no idea what you want to do. It just pulls up a bunch of key words. And, you know, the words are there. But the whole context of it and the obscurity of it is just, it's kind of asinine. It really is. Don't ever go to Google and try to look up something, especially if you want it to save your life. Because it ain't going to do it. You know, basically what I'm telling you is I got 3 full days into futzing with a transformer, windings on and off, back and forth. And it was a complete waste of time. I'd have been better off to throw this microwave in the trash can. But me being the type of person I am, you know, I don't have a lot of things. So I don't like to throw anything away. But if you want to try this, man, my heart goes out to you. I'm not saying it's impossible, but I'm just kind of telling you that it would never happen with this transformer here that I have in front of me. If it could, I would have pulled it off. So, you know, kind of reflecting, popping those bridges out of there made no difference. It almost seems like introducing more copper onto the core of it just agitates the problem. They said this transformer's ran in saturation, and you know, that just doesn't even make sense. Why putting more turns around the coil would have that impact on the magnetic field? I mean, everything about this is wrong. That's the only way to sum it up. Everything about this was entirely wrong. You know, maybe all those people that shoved 2 turns through one of these to make a little spot welder or something, maybe they just never bothered to tell you, hey, when I plug this thing in, it gets smoking hot. I mean, when you look stuff up, people don't tell you everything. They tell you what they want you to see, but they don't tell you any of the ill effects. They don't tell you how they got to where they got. They don't really give you any details. They just show you something and, you know, it looks great. More prime examples of just window dressing. That's all it is, window dressing. So, hey, anyway, thanks for watching my video. I'm sorry I couldn't give you a useful piece of information. That's really not what my channel is about. I definitely don't condone misinformation and failed experiments. You have a great day.